Hello, my name is Dr. Dawn Ewing. I'm the Executive Director of the International Academy of Biological Dentistry and Medicine. Is it possible to have a healthy root canal? I'd like to offer you some facts and some fiction. Even the best root canal, one that's done by an endodontist, which is a specialist that does root canals. First, they would remove as much of the pulp, the lymphatics, and the blood supply inside the pulp chamber of the tooth. They may be using a laser, some ozone, and sealers to seal the pulp chamber on the inside of the tooth. Even with all of this, the tooth may still fail. This illustration shows that the main canals of the tooth have been filled with putty, but you see two brown lines there that are called accessory canals. The dentist can't even see those, so that they're not aware that they're even there, and they can still contain flesh and nerve supply. 2,400 human teeth were injected with dye to determine the number of canals and their morphology. Can you see it's not just simply one or two canals? And many of these canals actually interconnect. This is just another illustration of how many canals can be inside a tooth and how they can connect to each other. Loma Linda University, with the help of Dr. Steinman, proved the flow of fluid through the tubules of a healthy tooth go from the inside towards the outside. Have you ever brushed your teeth at night and they're nice and slick before you go to bed, but when you wake up the next morning, there's some kind of a film that's all over them? If your tooth is healthy, it can detox. It can discard its waste through the tubules to the outside of the tooth. This means that there are microscopic openings in the tooth on the outside of the root, and that's not addressed in root canals. Here's a blow-up of what the tubules look like. They're little microscopic canals, or tunnels, if you will, that go from the inside of the tooth towards the outside. Let's pretend that we could sterilize this tooth. It's not possible, but let's pretend. What about the flesh left in the tubules that are on the sides of the tooth? As that flesh is robbed of life, it decays and turns into a breeding ground for bacteria and fungus. Here is an illustration. If you see a soup bone, you know what the marrow looks inside. If you look at the illustration on the left, the yellow is showing us where the pulp chamber is, and the blue lines show us the tubules and how they go sideways to the outside of the tooth. Those tubules will be filled with material that is very similar to the marrow in a soup bone. Anaerobic bacteria finds its way into the sides of the tooth through those openings and now is in a heaven of sorts. It's a dark, moist, warm environment with a lot of decaying flesh to eat. As it thrives, it multiplies and can move back outside the tooth and spread to other areas of the body, even to adjoining jawbone or remote areas, setting up secondary infections. The growth of different bacteria and yeast inside those tubules has been documented. You want evidence? The presence of anaerobic microbes was discovered in the blood and root canals analyzed from 26 patients with absolutely no pain symptoms. The anaerobic bacteria found could cause pneumonia, acne, necrotic tissue infections, among other ailments. These pathogens also serve as major inflammatory mediators, inducing disease in the body. Pseudomonas. Some strains of this bacteria are antibiotic resistant and can ultimately cause death. Symptoms associated are a weakened immune system, pneumonia, and blood infections. Staphylococci, commonly referred to as staph. These bacteria cause skin infections, pneumonia, blood poisoning, and toxic shock syndrome. Streptococci, some strains of this bacteria can be referred to as flesh-eating bacteria. This bacteria is linked to symptoms related to strep throat and serious health complications involving pain, fever, swelling, dizziness, rash, confusion, abnormal blood pressure, and toxic shock syndrome. Enterococcus feacalis. The presence of this bacteria is often the cause of urinary tract infections, meningitis, and is also one of the most antibiotic-resistant bacteria known. These bacteria are thought to stimulate the production of toxins and further infections in the entire body. It's one of the most prevalent and virulent bacteria strains present in an infected root canal, and it's also the most commonly discovered after a root canal treatment is done. One of the original founding members of the Root Canal Association was Dr. Meinig. He commented on a study performed by Dr. Weston Price in the early 1900s. Dr. Meinig noted that the cause of secondary infections is not solely dependent on the presence of pathogenic bacteria, but also the production of toxins produced from those bacteria. Dr. Price's research team found that implanting an infected tooth from a human to another animal would cause the same systemic complication to the animal in which the human was suffering. In fact, Dr. Price ran very well-controlled experiments contrary to popular medical rumors and discovered that animals infected with the toxins alone had a significantly higher rate of becoming sick or dying. Ozone and laser, yes, they're amazing. Can you see this piece of flesh with all the bugs eating it? If you spray it with chemicals or ozone or laser it, you'll kill every one of those bacteria. But more will come because you've not done anything about removing the decaying flesh. Get the picture? The decaying flesh is inside those tubules. I personally have never seen a root canal tooth that's been sent off for culture and had it come back sterile. Matter of fact, it's not come back anything other than diseased and filled with all kinds of things, including Borrelia and botulinum. I have a report from an extracted root canal tooth that was treated at the highest level of endodontics. 3 weeks after treatment, it was extracted and sent off, only to confirm extreme infections. Here is that tooth. This particular tooth had so much bacteria in it that it reduced the body's ability to create ATP due to enzyme inhibition by 38%. This same patient complaining of chronic fatigue 6 months later after they spent a fortune to, quote, re-sterilize their root canal teeth. Made a personal choice to have those three teeth removed. We sent them off. Those three teeth collectively reduced the body's ability to create ATP, which is what you need in order to have energy in your body. It was reduced by 78%. No wonder she had chronic fatigue. Here's some good books, in case you don't believe me. One by Dr. Meinig, and one by Dr. Levy and Dr. Kulatz. Now, having said everything that I've said about the bacteria and recognizing that there's no such an animal as a sterilized root canal tooth, you have to understand that the largest problem is that you took a part of the body that was alive and able to conduct electricity, only to kill it and block electricity from going through that area permanently. Try taking a lamp that works and remove 1 inch of the wire from inside that cord. Plug it in and you're not going to be able to get the bulb to come on. The gap where the wire was removed might be sterile or it could be sitting in stachybotra mold. I don't care. The issue of why the lamp is not working is the electrical disconnect. In order to fix the lamp, an electrician would splice the wire together completely, removing any gap to restore the lamp's ability to function as it was designed. People, your body is electric. Your dead tooth is the gap in the wire. Can you tell me which of these dead people is the healthiest? A root canal is a dead tooth. It's not possible to have a healthy, dead anything. True, some people's immune system can tolerate smoking, bad diet, stress, even a dead tooth, while other people die from secondhand smoke or secondary infections. I do not advocate removing every root canal tooth in every patient, but I do strongly suggest that every root canal tooth be evaluated, as an incredible number of them fail over time or cause severe health consequences that most MDs or DOs are unable to find the root cause of. Find a biological dentist that can use a CBCT or someone who can offer bioenergetic testing to see what kind of a burden these root canal tooth might have to your optimal health. We now find it in more x-rays using the CBCT. Even conventional dentists are starting to recognize failure in root canal teeth. Notice where the red arrows are and the bone is darkened. So the question is, how much good health do you have to give away? Need more references? You could send your root canal tooth off to see what bacteria is in it if you're curious. You need to find a biological dentist. Go to www.iabdm.org. Email us, call us if you need to. Let us help you. Thanks for listening.